the Vegetarian Union of Latin America, and Latin American coordinator for Food for Life Global, the world's largest vegan food relief. Please welcome Juliana Castaneda Turner.
I'm going to do a short resume of the situation for animals in Latin America and in South America. South America is one of the largest export part of the continent in the world. In 2017, the beef export from South America was still dominated by Brazil. However, shipments were all for Argentina, Paraguay, and Uruguay. We have to see Uruguay is the smaller country in South America, and it's one of the biggest exporters of meat. We also have big exportation of dairy. In 2017, South America was recognized for the international trade in dairy products after New Zealand and Australia. The country that is foremost dairy products in Latin America produces 53% of the dairy in the world. That's a huge number. And it's either from Brazil, Mexico, Argentina, and Uruguay. There is not too much animal protection laws in South America, but the countries who have money as Panama, Argentina, Costa Rica, Brazil, Uruguay, Colombia, Peru, and Mexico. So I want to talk a little bit about Latin America psychology because it's totally different from the psychology in Europe and of course in North America. So I want to give the example of what happened in my country, Colombia. Hundreds of activists in my country were very hard with the government to make the first animal protection law. One when I was working, that was 2 years ago, we cannot use them. But of course, when I talk about animal protection laws, I'm talking just about those things. Because, you know, that's what people consider animals. But are not working because we don't have a police or a part of the government who reinforce this. So I'm going to give you a horrible and short example. For example, a guy was caught on camera raping a dog, a little girl. He was caught on camera, and he got to jail for a few hours, and he got signed because there is no proof that he continued doing that. Seems like nobody was recording that that happened all the time. So in the way that our animal protection laws work, we have to proof, like a video of what is happening. And believe me, if you see someone raping a dog, you don't want to record a video to the police. You're going to hit the street. It's not like, oh, I'm going to see the video, I'm going to the police. It's not going to happen. So, in my 20 years that I'm doing activism in my country, and know the experience that I have, animal protection laws don't work in countries than Latin America. For example, in Colombia, there is another law that if you put trash in the street or something like that, you can go 8 days to jail and 3 months of your basic salary. Never happened. You have to see how your team voted that. Nobody goes to jail for the garbage. So, because there is no someone behind to enforce this law. Colombia is one of the biggest countries with full fighting, thanks to our Spanish tradition. So it's very legal and has a big support from the government because, as you can imagine, it's promote for the people with more power and money in the country. We were very lucky that a few years ago, the mayor of the city of Bogota, is the main city in Colombia, his name is Gustavo Petro. He was very smart, and he cannot prohibit the bullfighting, but what he did, the place where the bullfighting is run by the government. He didn't want to rent. He said, no, I don't want to rent for the bullfighting this year. And he built a library to promote animal protection and work order. So in that year that Gustavo Petro was the mayor of our country, there was no bullfighting because they don't have a place to do it. So these people that have running have little places where they practice in privacy bullfighting. But we try. This is still legal, this is still part of the tradition, and this is still in the people consider that it's art in my country. There is many activists working against the bullfighting in our country, not only in our country, but in the parts of South America that there is bullfighting. One of these activists is my friend Chucho Merchan, that is back there. He's a very fun musician, and this night is going to be playing with. And to say. applied to the animal rights conference, you can miss that. So, like animal protection laws don't work, the government is not too helpful, like the country is wrong with those people who don't care about animals. So, in 20 years of experience, education is the only answer for Latin America. I believe that education is the only hope for a better future. We have to be very passionate in the countries of Latin America, but we're going in the good way. So that is when I say, I have to do something. I became vegetarian when I was 6 years old, when my mother, I like to cook, my mother cook too. And I asked my mother how does the tree with the burgers. My mother said, oh, it's not a tree. It's not a tree, it's an animal. I said, never did, I don't eat meat. I was 8 years old, 12 years ago, when I was in the school, when I was 11 years old, the teacher was doing the classic question, what do you want to do when you grow up? And I didn't have something in mind in the moment, but in the moment she was in front of me, asked me, I said, I'm going to buy a big place and I'm going to save all the animals in the world. I always call myself more an action person than a grown person. So the next day that teacher said that, he said, okay, now I have to buy a big place to save all the animals in the world. So I started to sell cookies and chocolates and candies in the school, and I saved money, enough money. I was 11 years old. When I was 26 years old, I had the money to buy the first one, and that is when I started the first sanctuary in South America, 12 years ago. And so far, it's the only farm sanctuary in my country, Colombia. We have, there is two in Chile, one in Uruguay, and one in Argentina. So we are fine total. Then in my 25 years, I saved more than 766 animals. And I started my educational projects that are, this year, thanks to Joanna Harper, the founder photographer, she has a project that is called the Unborn Project, that is about women in the front of the animal rights. I was one of the lucky person who belonged to that project, and the only Latin American woman in the project. And that gave me the chance to get a grant to do three of my strongest educational programs. That is a free vegan cooking classes that I have a trip to many people. So all the vegans want to take vegan cook lessons. But I say, if you want it for free, you have to bring one of your parents. It's very smart. I am a mother, and I don't. You always see that all these teenagers want to go vegan, but one they say to the parents freak out, like, oh, you want to die. But believe, I am a mother, and I don't think that the parents, but no, you have to kill animals to survive. No, the parents are always worried about your nutrition and all this. You know, any parent want a bad kid who want to kill animals, it's not in their mind. So I want to bring this up. So if we work with the teenagers and the kids and we share the mind and they say, yes, we're going vegan, but they go home and mom is not going vegan. So it's like we are doing half of the work. So I want to do the whole work. I want to do that with these kids that want to go vegan, go home, the mother says, okay, I'm going to put your vegan meal. So that is why I start this program. So the parents came to me and see that I also am a mother and I was pregnant when I was being vegan and my kid is totally healthy, so they trust. And say, okay, this is good. And many parents go vegan and we have many vegan families right now with these delicious meals. thanks to the Unborn Project too, I start with a friend in Chile. I want to say that my animal sanctuary, we also rescue dogs and cats. It's impossible to do it. There is too many strict dogs and cats in my country. So this is very nice because even when we are vegans, let's be honest, we have more connection with the dog and cat because it's the one that's sleeping in our bed, it's the one we feed daily. So there is more connection. So many people come to the sanctuary to see the dogs and the cat, and then they see that close to the dog there is a pig that like that it rubs too and play with the food, and it's just like the dog. Some people, it's easy for people to make the connection because they are seeing the animal that they had in home and the other animal exactly the same. So it's very easy for people to make the connection. And this gave me the idea to make a coming from with my friend in Chile to a super dog that is called a Kiltro from the future. Kiltro is the name that the street animals received in Chile. And Kyoto is coming from the future to save all the farm animals in the present. And we, of course, put animals in the sanctuary, so when the kids see the comic, they see that everyone is real. Even Kyoto is a real dog. The pig is real, and they come to see in the sanctuary, and they see all the superheroes are real, and this is happening. We launched this, we give this, all these free comics for free in the schools and with the people who visit the sanctuary. I promote in radio stations and, well, many nice places. We had many international volunteers. It's great. I have volunteers from all over the world. German, Israel, Australia, England, Belgium, many people from the US because we are very close to you. And these people is spreading the word of what is happening in Colombia. We are also again the coordinator of Food for Life Global. We distribute vegan food for people around the world. I have right now 4 programs in South America, Argentina, 2 in Argentina, 1 in Chile, 2 in Colombia, and 1 in Ecuador. Okay, so we have 3 street dogs because the number of street dogs are big in our country. Is Siam, the horse, and Arjuna, who was hit by a car, but he's paralytic right now, but very happy. So that is what I see. People see this and say they are equals. They are equals. I cannot eat them. It's very easy to make the connection to them. That is Paula, very smiling. And the kids made the connection very easy. Because when kids come to the center, they say, raise their hand, the one who likes the orbit of dogs. And they say, oh, we don't eat dogs. Why don't we not eat dogs? Well, dogs are animals. And make the connection immediately, yeah, we don't eat animals. We receive people from all over the world, people hold the animals, we eat the best vegan food, we touch the pigs like that they are dogs. I want to close with a very short video, a few seconds. 1 week and a half before I was getting ready to come to the conference, one of my more difficult rescues took me 3 days to rescue Paula the pig. And she died 1 week and a half ago. And when she was dying, I was close to her, and I promised her that I'm going to talk about her for the rest of my life. And I don't want that any pig or any animal suffer like Paula suffered. And I want that everybody know Paula, and everybody talk about Paula in the name of all the animals that cannot die like Paula did. I was hugging Paula with Sheila. There's many in the slaughter that nobody's hugging. So thank you so much, and hope to play this video.
Just click on it. Just click on it. It should play. Put the microphone down.